We're looking at re-election. We need more Democratic votes. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah, I'll talk to you later.
President, it's for you. We still up for that round of golf later?
Tim, get the vice president here right now. And Tim, tell my wife to keep her phone on.
Are we gonna make it through this, sir?
I don't know. Give me the Secretary of Defense.
Vice President, sir, you need to get to the White House as soon as possible. Okay, and sir, be careful. It's nasty out there. Vice President should be here shortly.
Tim, we're in a hell of a mess here.
Sir, we need a plan of action. Sir, we need a plan of action.
God damn it, Tim, let me think!
How could this happen?
Communicating with them started to become hostile about a month ago. We could only suppress it for so long. A war like this was bound to occur.
So then why were we caught with our pants down? Why wasn't I, your Secretary of Defense, notified about it?
It's above your pay grade.
What?
You! The people of this great nation, no one is supposed to know about this. I barely know about this. This is bigger than you and I. This is bigger than all of us.
Oh, God.
We need a plan, sir.
Wait until the vice president gets here.
They could have slaughtered him. Ripped his limbs from his torso. Drank his blood.
Get it together! We are the leaders of this country, and we need to lead the people. There are millions, no, billions of people looking for direction, for safety. We need to give them direction, or the enemy will triumph over us like a boy destroying an anthill. We have overcome adversity before. We have beaten the Black Plague, the Holocaust. We will continue to thrive! Humankind will live on.
Give me DTA.
Clearance code, Churchill.
What is DTA?
You didn't think you could start this party without me. They were everywhere. A bloodbath out there.
What's the death toll?
Millions. It's like nothing I've ever seen before. The size of one doesn't matter. You have an army of billions on your back. This is genocide. Not of a nation or a race, but a species. Our species. You ever seen the devil? You ever thought of what he looked like? As a kid, I always thought the devil was red with horns. No. The devil is what is at our doorstep. I lost Jane. I watched the life leave her body. The light in her eyes die out. I felt the warmth of her body fade I watched the love of my life die. And I couldn't do anything about it. I was useless. I was unavailable. I was weak. Is that you? Are you safe? I love you. Who's out there? Who's out there? Who's hurting you? Is it the Russians? The women? The children? Who's doing this to you? Gnomes. They're called Tomtonitians. And the reason why we're at war with them is because of pricks like you.
Is it that hard to call people by their respected names instead of racial slurs? You, along with millions of other people, are to blame, and millions of people will die because of it.
And you! I warned you about this. I told you this exact thing would happen if you didn't get your head out of your ass.
Who do you think you are?
He's DTA.
Is that supposed to mean something to me? Because it doesn't.
Quincy Norton, Director of Tomtonitian Affairs.
I don't care who you are or what title you have. You don't talk to the most important man in the free world like that.
Son, I write his checks.
Why didn't I know about this man or his organization? I told you it's all above your pay grade. The Tomtonitian Defense League is above all of us.
It's clearance level 11. I thought it only went up to 8.
Son, there are a lot of things you don't know about. Do you remember the Tomtonitian invasion of 06?
No.
Exactly.
I'm not buying this bull. This guy is an imaginative bum who gets off.
Son, we live in a dirty world. A world filled with creatures and monsters ready to tear you apart. And who do you think is going to protect the people from these monsters? You? The president? No. It takes a special breed of man to take down these demons, and that's where I come in. I do unspeakable deeds so that you and the rest of the world can keep your hands clean and get to sleep at night. I am the reason that people can live without fear. I am the keystone in humanity's survival.
You think you're honorable. You thrive on the recognition of your deeds. You live on the satisfaction. There is no honor in my line of duty, nor is there recognition for my actions. But I do what needs to be done.
You—
I don't give a damn what you think of me as a person. I am here to do what God or whatever higher power gave me to do, my job. And that's exactly what I am going to do. So step aside because the professionals are working.
So the Tomtonitians are gnomes?
It doesn't matter what they are.
Yes, it does. It does to the people who are losing their loved ones outside these walls, these doors.
Don't you get it, kid? There's no stopping this. So sit back and have a drink, because it'll probably be your last. They've allowed us to live on their world for thousands of years. Of course they would take it back sometime.
What?
Open your eyes. Death is inevitable. The quicker you come to that conclusion, the more enjoyment you can get out of this godforsaken life you were lucky enough to have.
So killing millions of people in the process is okay? It's justifiable?
What is the value of one human life compared to the billions that could be lost? We kill a few million people and the problem is solved.
A few million? You heartless bastard! You're no different than the gnomes if you talk like that!
They are called Tomtonitians, and I'm talking about the greater good. I am looking into the future. The human race will cease to exist without these actions.
So so genocide is the only answer?
You're goddamn right it is! What are you doing? The odds of survival diminish with every second wasted. And you're what? Getting a buzz on?
Do what you think is right. I'm not gonna make this call.
Okay then, let's go to the bomb shelter. Washington, D.C. is about to be nuked.
No.
No to what? The nuking? You just gave me the power to do that.
No to the bomb shelter. I'm the leader of this nation, and I need to lead them right now. Take yourself and the others to the shelter. I need to get in front of a camera. Tim.
Yes, sir?
You find my wife and you take care of her.
Of course. It's not too late to come with.
No. I need to be the crutch that this broken nation leans on. I need to address my people. I need to take a rain check on that round of golf, Tim.
It was a pleasure working with you, sir.
My fellow Americans, I am here to talk to you about the problem at hand. Today, we face an evil that we have never faced before.
There is only one solution that is more effective than any other. Unity.
We must put down our differences and fight next to one another for one another.
Throughout history, mankind has fought against itself. But today, I'm asking you to band together to defeat adversity.
Adversity. A petty word that has no meaning to the human race anymore.
At one time, it did hold true to its definition.
People were powerless to it, until we realized that all it is a word filled with empty threats.
An empty threat that can be conquered, that has been conquered, and that will be conquered again.
This is not humanity's last day. No, this is the beginning of a new chapter of a new world.
We the people have the pen in our hands. We can choose what to write. Should we write the demise of an entire species or the triumph of a civilization? It is up to you to decide. One thing is for certain. We will not falter in the presence of fear. We will rise up and defeat the enemy together as one.
I woke up this morning thinking about spending time with the people I care most about in this life. It's funny that in the course of a few hours, your whole life can be shattered.
But as long as you have all of the pieces, it can be put back together. Hope is the glue that bonds those broken pieces.
Hope is what will get humanity through this crisis. Hope gives you the will to get up when you have fallen down. Never give up. No matter what the circumstance.
Life is short. Enjoy every moment and live it to its fullest.